In our previous video of landmarks, we dealt with cusps. In this video, we will be dealing with the second landmark, that is the ridge. Watch the video till the end to understand it well. Hi, we at Dentarise welcome you all to a platform where we help you to conceptualize, visualize and memorize dentistry. Starting with the definition of ridge as given by Wheelers, a ridge is any linear elevation on the surface of a tooth and is named according to its location. Like the cusp, a ridge is also an elevation, but a ridge can be present on any surface of the tooth unlike a cusp which was only present on the occlusal surface. And depending upon the location where the ridge is present, it is given a name. Let's see how. Let's deal with the first type of ridge, that is the marginal ridge. As the name implies, a ridge means an elevation. Marginal means they are present on the margins. First of all, let's look at where these ridges are present. In incisors and canines, these are present on the lingual surface. In premolars and molars, they are present on the occlusal surface. Now let's focus on the term marginal. Marginal implies margins. This implies they face towards the two proximal surfaces of the tooth, that is the mesial surface and the distal surface. Just a repetition, mesial surface face towards the midline and the distal surface face away from the midline. If you're not clear with this concept, please do check out our video on surfaces and ridges of the tooth. The link is given in the description below. The marginal ridge present on the mesial side is called as the mesial marginal ridge. The marginal ridge present on the distal side will be called as the distal marginal ridge. Now let's understand these marginal ridges with the help of figures. As I have already mentioned, in the incisors and canines, these marginal ridges are present on the lingual surface. Here you can see in the figure. The marginal ridge which faces towards the mesial side will be called as the mesial marginal ridge, marked in the figure in red, and the marginal ridges facing towards the distal side will be called as the distal marginal ridge. Just remember, these ridges are present originally on the lingual surface. We are naming these according to the surfaces towards which these ridges face. Similarly, we can see in the mandibular incisors and canines, the one facing towards the mesial side are marked in red and are called as the mesial marginal ridge. The ones facing towards the distal side are marked in green and are called as the distal marginal ridge. Now coming to the posterior teeth, that is the premolars and molars, the marginal ridges are present on the occlusal surface. Rest all remains the same. The marginal ridge facing towards the mesial side are called as the mesial marginal ridge, marked in red, and the marginal ridge facing towards the distal side will be called as the distal marginal ridge, marked in green. Similarly, you can observe in mandibular first premolar and mandibular second premolar as well. In the same way, you can observe in the maxillary molars and the mandibular molars. The only difference is that these marginal ridges are present on the lingual surface in anterior teeth and on the occlusal surface in the posterior teeth. Rest all remains the same. The one facing towards the mesial side will be called as the mesial marginal ridge, and the one facing towards the distal side will be called as the distal marginal ridge. Now let's deal with the second type of ridge, that is the triangular ridge. Again, it is an elevation but present on the occlusal surface of premolars and molars, which start from the tips of cusps of these teeth and then move towards the central part of the occlusal surface. Now let's look over the fact that why they are called as a triangular ridge. They are named so because the slopes of each side of the ridge are inclined to resemble two sides of a triangle. Have a look at the figure. Now let's discuss how do we actually name these triangular ridges. It's very simple. You just have to name the ridge according to the cusp on which they are present. For example, the triangular ridge on the mesiobuccal cusp is called as the triangular ridge of the mesiobuccal cusp. In the same way, we can name the triangular ridge of the mesiolingual cusp, the triangular ridge of the distobuccal cusp, and the triangular ridge of the distolingual cusp. Notice the triangular ridge present in the maxillary first premolar and the maxillary second premolar. The same pattern, they start from the tips of cusp of these teeth and then move towards the central part of the occlusal surface. In the same way in mandibular first premolar and mandibular second premolar. In the mandibular second premolar, since we have three cusps present, so we will be having three triangular ridges also. Notice the triangular ridge present in the maxillary molars and the mandibular molars. Let's look at the third type of ridge, that is the oblique ridge. This oblique ridge is present on the occlusal surface of maxillary molars. It is called as oblique ridge because it passes through the occlusal surface in an oblique manner. For this, keep your eyes on the distobuccal cusp and the mesiolingual cusp. It starts from the triangular ridge of the distobuccal cusp, continues down and then fuses with the distal cusp ridge of the mesiolingual cusp. If we notice the mesiolingual cusp, we can see two inclines. The one incline facing towards the mesial side will be called as the mesial cusp ridge of the mesiolingual cusp, and the one incline that is marked in blue facing towards the distal side is called as the distal cusp ridge of the mesiolingual cusp. The oblique ridge will be formed by the fusion of this triangular ridge of the distobuccal cusp continuing down to fuse with the distal cusp ridge of the mesiolingual cusp. Observe the figure, relate to the tooth, and then this concept will be clear. So with this, we complete with the ridges present on the surface of the tooth. The rest of the landmarks are dealt in the subsequent videos. Thank you for watching. If you like our content, please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Suggestions are always welcome from your side. Check out our rest of the videos as well. Stay tuned, stay safe.